backup. We have front flicks with and without a delay. We have a plethora of side flicks, again with or without a delay. And now we go to the last basic directional flick, but one that is very deceptive, the backflip. Now, when you talk of mileage, this one doesn't get used near as much as the front and side, but has great uses. But with newer players using it purely for recovery, and some old school players still doing some of the sneaky methods with it from the old days, I'm gonna put it as a C on the tier list. But the backflip actually has some good uses. So let's talk about the two main methods of backflip. You've got the recovery backflip, and you've got the slip and hit backflip. Let's talk about the recovery backflip. This is a great weapon when you've lost control of your speed or you're unaware of your surroundings and the ball is near the back of your car. Once the ball is near the back of your car, if it's at the right point, you can do a backflip and it will pop the ball into the air. This is great because it can buy you some time, as if you keep the ball in that position on the car without knowledge of where the opponent is, the chance of getting dunked on is high. You have nothing behind the hitbox, so anytime you've gone too fast and the ball is positioned towards the back of your car, just do a backflip to get better vision and recovery time, unless you know where the defender is and you can slow down and let the ball come forward so that you can move on to your other moves. So this requires the ball to be fairly near the back, but not all the way. In fact, it's basically half a ball's length off the center. If you're coming up the ranks and you're still getting used to switching in and out of ball cam, the moment you would want to do the backflip is the second the ball camera switches and points backwards. That's when you execute this flip, and that's when you'll get the maximum height on it. So great for recovery, just to give you some time, and of course can be done on purpose if you want to accelerate and then sort of pull the rug from underneath the opponent as they dive in. The slip and hit backflip. This used to be such a popular move. Much like the double pop, it faded into obscurity with people wanting a cleaner looking game. Yet it's still so effective and works so well. So imagine, we're on the wing. We cut infield and we have the ball moving across the opponent's path, but it's fairly close to them. Now, ideally, you would look to sort of turn away and maybe go for a solid 50 or a side flip flick, or even you could just wrap it across and take it to the other side for a boost off. However, another option is as we turn, we can accelerate so the ball goes towards the back of the car and then we do a backflip. This works really well because the ball has a high amount of forward momentum when you execute the backflip. So if you take a tiny angle, so start to turn the nose of your car, only slightly though, you will get the ball rolling off your car towards the opponent's goal. That way, when you do the backflip, not only will it lift the ball up and slow it down, but it also gives it a slight bit of momentum towards the net, often leaving the defender in a rough spot. So literally, just drag it infield towards the net, accelerate, turn away from the ball and then backflip. So there it is, another two simple weapons we have to add to our game. So thank you all for watching, I do appreciate it, and also a huge thank you to the Patreons for having coaching, replay analysis and just helping out the channel. That is Trenton, Dream Crusher, Mika, Callum, Evil Sam, Dark Money and Cameron. Do really appreciate it, everybody. Thank you so much for that. Coming soon, we have more of the meaty flicks, which I know a lot of you are looking forward to. So as always, look after yourself, have a nice life, and peace out. Peace.